Hello and welcome to this Google Sheets Tips video. I am Sumit Bansal, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to insert and use a checkbox in Google Sheets. So I'd first cover how to insert a checkbox and everything you need to know about it. And then I would also show you two really cool examples. The first one is this interactive to-do list where I have the task and the status. And as soon as you click on the status, you would see that this entire row becomes green and the task gets checked off. So you can easily come here, check these tasks, and these would be cut off and marked as done. The other example that I want to show you is of a chart where I have this data that is being used to create this profit margin chart for 2019. And the user has the option to check this checkbox. And as soon as it's checked, additional data appears in the chart. See what happens when I click on 2020 checkbox? This line of 2020 data appears. And when I click on 2021 forecasted data, then another line appears. So you can also create interactive charts using checkboxes. So let's see how to do this. Inserting a checkbox in Google Sheets is really easy. Select the cell where you want to insert the checkbox. Go to the insert option here in the menu and then click on the checkbox option. And as soon as you do that, you'll see that the checkbox appears in the cell. If you want to insert the checkbox in multiple cells, then you select multiple cells, let's say all these 10 cells here. Again, go to the insert option and then click on checkbox. And as soon as you do that, all the cells that are selected would now have a checkbox. Now, let me delete this and come back to cell A1. Now, how do you use this checkbox? Very simple. You come to this cell, hover over the checkbox, click on it, and you can see that it's checked, and click on it again, and the check would go away. Now, the way this works is when you check a checkbox, you can see here in the formula bar, it says true, which means that the value of the cell where the checkbox has been checked is true, and the value of the cell where the checkbox has been unchecked is false. So this is how we are going to use the checkbox in calculations and in creating interactive to-do lists, because as soon as I check this, I know that this cell's value has become true, and now I can use this value in the calculations. Another thing that you need to know is that if you have a checkbox in a cell, then you cannot have anything else. You cannot have the checkbox and some additional text here. You can only have the checkbox. Also, this checkbox is a part of the cell. So if you delete the cell or if you hide the cell, then the checkbox would also continue to stick with the cell, and it would also get deleted and it would also get hidden. In case you want to color this, you can just color this like any cell. Come here and give it a color, and like with the cell, the checkbox would also get the same color. So it just becomes a part of the cell. Now, let's see how to create an interactive to-do list using checkboxes. Here I have a task list and I have the status column where I want to insert the checkboxes. And I want to use it in such a way that when I check the checkbox, then this entire record should turn green and this text should get cut off, which would be an indication that this task has been completed. The first step would be to insert the checkboxes here. So I would select these cells, go to the insert option, and then click on checkbox. And instantly, you can see all these checkboxes. Now, as I mentioned, when the checkbox is unchecked, the value of this cell is false. And when I check this, the value of it becomes true. Now, I'm going to use this value to use conditional formatting to apply the formatting that would make sure that when this is checked, it turns green and the text is cut off. Now, in conditional formatting, you can use a formula, and that formula needs to return either a true or a false, and based on it, the formatting is applied. So we are going to use that property where I would select all these cells, go to the format option here, and then click on conditional formatting. This would open the conditional formatting rules pane here. And in this case, I would go to format cells if option and click on this drop down and select custom formula is. Now I need to enter a formula that should return a true when this is checked off and a false when this is not checked. And that is exactly the value of the cell. So here the formula is very, very simple. It's simply $B2. And the reason I'm using $B2 is because when I use a dollar before the column letter, column alphabet, it would make sure that when all the cells in this entire range, which is A2 and B2, are being analyzed, only the value in cell B2 is being considered. So when conditional formatting checks whether it should highlight cell A2 and cut off the text in cell A2 or not, it would refer to the cell in B2. And when it checks that condition for B2, it would still refer to B2. Then when it comes down to cell A3, it would still refer to B3. And then for B3, it would still refer to B3. So this is how, when you lock the column, then only that column values would be referred. And that is it. My formatting is already green here. If you want to change the color, you can change the color from here. I would stick with green, and I would also apply the strike through format and click on done. And that is it. Now, when I come back here and I click on this checkbox, you can see a green color is applied and the text is cut off. And I can do this for all these cells. And in case you revert it, you uncheck the box, then the formatting would go away. So this is how you can easily create an interactive to-do list using checkboxes in Google Sheets. Now let's see another example where we can create an interactive chart using checkboxes. So here I have the data, and this is, let's say, profit margin data for 4 quarters in 2019-20 and 2020-21 forecasted data. And if I create a chart using it, then it would be a simple chart that would be based on this data. So let's select this data, click on insert, and then click on chart. This inserts a default chart here, and it also opens this chart editor. In this case, I would click on the chart type and then select combination chart or combo chart and close this. And this is the chart that this data has inserted for me. Now, as of now, this chart is not interactive. You have this data here, and that entire data is populated in the chart. But what I really want is to have a checkbox for 2020 and 2021 F so that apart from 2019 data, the user has the ability to show 2020 and 2021 forecasted data in the chart. So let me delete this chart and first create the construct for it. So the first thing I would do is come here and enter 2020. Here I would put 2021 forecast, and then two checkboxes here. So I would select these two cells, go to insert, and then insert the checkbox. Now, let me make this bold. Now, the next thing I need to do is somehow make my chart data dependent on these checkboxes. Now, that cannot happen with this data because this is already there. What I can do is create a copy of this data, let's say here, and this data can be dependent on these checkboxes so that if I click on 2020, then only this data appears, else this data is not plotted on the chart. So to do that, first let's insert the 2019 data, because this is always going to be on in the chart. Let's just have it anyway. So I just use the reference for this data here. Now in 2020 data, if I check this checkbox, I want the data, else I don't. So what I'm going to do is use a formula, a simple if formula, where my condition would be this cell here, and I would lock this by pressing F4, which means that even when I copy this formula to the right, I do not want this cell reference to change in the formula. And the condition here would be, if this is true, then I want this data, else I want a blank. A very simple formula. And as of now, you can see it's returning a blank. But when I click on 2020, it would instantly get me this data. And similarly, I can do this for 2021F. So here again, an if condition where this is the condition, because it returns true and false, I just need to have the cell reference for these cells that have the checkboxes. Again, press F4 to lock this. If this is true, which means this is checked off, I want this value, else I want a blank. And again, copy this here. And now if I check this, you can see this data appears. Now I'm going to use this data to plot my chart. So I select this data, go to insert, and here click on chart. It again inserts the default chart here. I would go to setup, column chart, and select combo chart, and then close this. Now I'm not going to customize this chart, but you can obviously customize this chart as per your requirement. And here you have an interactive chart where, see what happens when I uncheck these two, my data goes away. As of now, it's only 2019 data, but when I click here, my line for 2020 appears, and when I click here, the line for 2021 forecasted data appears as well. So this is how you can easily create an interactive chart. These can be really useful when you are creating dashboards and reports and want to give the user the flexibility where they first only want to compare 2020 and 2019 data. Then you can remove the clutter from the chart by allowing the user to deselect some data, and when they want to get that data back, they can simply check this. So this is how you can use checkboxes in Google Sheets to create interactive charts. That's it in this video. I hope you found this useful. Also, if you're liking these videos, please subscribe to this YouTube channel and click on the bell icon so that you never miss out on any new Google Sheets tips video I come up with. Thank you and have a nice day.